Hello and welcome everyone! Yeah, today we are going to take a look at the bottomless pot and what you can do with it. Also, don't mind this normal house in the background. We'll get to that in a later video. And also, don't mind my outfit. Right now I'm working on the Hyrule Island again, but we're going back to the roots. This time we'll do a building techniques video part 2. So if you have missed the first one, I'll put it at the end of this video, and maybe also my Hyrule build, so you also know how I spent my time while not making some videos. Yay! So, but we're here for the bottomless pot. What we are going to do is I'm going to show you how you can remove water in two different ways, and how you can fill water in very fast. So hopefully this will be kind of helpful for you. If so, please consider to like this video. This would make me very happy. Yay! So let's go to the beach. Son of a beach. Oh wait, before we do that, you'll need to have the unlocked version of the bottomless pot, or the upgraded one. You'll have to... Ah, beautiful. Ah, the Japanese people are crazy. This was also in the top 3 one day ago. And a Gundam. Ah, and a Link. Completely made out of wood. So, for one of those tricks to work, you'll need the upgraded bottomless pot. And you can see it, as you can see at the bottom right, rewards list. You'll get it once you have completed 45 tablet targets. Also, I need to correct something I said in an earlier video. When you want to unlock the epilogue with all the monsters, you don't need 45 different rooms. You want to have 45 different tablet targets complete. There you can also see 60 tablet targets, and you'll get the binoculars, which is this handy device. So you can edit everything at a 16 block radius around you, also with any tool you have. Like, let's pick this up and put it down again. Like this. But you need the bottomless pot upgrades so you can collect lava. We'll need that now. So imagine you want to have this whole area completely dry so you can build on it. What you want to do is use your bottomless pot with lava and pour it in. And you won't pour lava, you'll pour solid, what is it, shirt? Or umber? Shirt. Sometimes there will still be some spots left, but you can just fill them. It's still a lot. Ah, that's because there were some plants. And some stones. So you want to remove everything beforehand, so you don't have those tiny spots of lava. And now you can just go ahead. So the radius of the pot is 7 blocks. So we'll just go over here and count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we'll pour into here. And that's one of the fastest ways to make new ground floor. We can also pour some seawater over here. Collect the lava again. Fill it. And now we'll convert this piece of water also to solid stone. We'll scrap this part. Didn't work out as planned. So there's also another way to remove water without turning it to solid ground. We'll just pour some water over here and wait a bit. And there you can see the evaporation process begins and all the water is removed. Now you can recollect it. Wait a bit. Like this. And make sure not to pour it too close to the water, otherwise you'll have those other solid ground pieces also lava. It's also nice, those lava blocks. And I would recommend to use this other kind of armor. Wait, what is it called? This one, because you won't get damaged by lava. So also don't let the lava sit there for too long, otherwise you'll have a little problem on your hands. But this is one of the fastest ways to remove water from your island. So as you can see, those don't trigger the evaporation process because they are not on the mini-map. So you need to increase the field a bit. Like this. And now it's on the mini-map and the evaporation process begins. That way you can also remove water fast. Then just replace it again with sand. So make sure to do this on land, because otherwise it won't be recognized. Like over here. The water is still on top of it, and so it doesn't work. But once you enter this area and extend it a bit, now you can see on the minimap. Also it takes care of ghosts, because it's light. They don't like it.
Ah, my eyes!
And then you just replace it again. Sometimes also some dancing flames will spawn. For those, you'll either need a bucket of water or the Aurora Blade, because this one can take care of those. But I would recommend to just convert everything to solid ground and maybe then just take the golem and destroy everything. Or just stand in water and do it from there. So imagine over here. Put two blocks down and then just pour. This is one of the fastest methods to create solid ground. Over here. So, if you want to create an island, like maybe over there, because there is an area where you can still build, right over here. If you want to create a little island, this is the way to go. You'll just...
Ah, what are you doing here? Hello!
You'll just create some pillar made out of stone. You can also do it like this, with the binoculars. Just stand on it and build away. All you have to do is hold the button and you'll go up until you hit the ceiling. So, but now we're here. And what you want to do is pour. As you've noticed, this didn't work because we don't have solid ground below us. So what you need to do is put one block over here and one over there. And now it should work if I didn't break up the water surface. Yeah, it works. And now you got the beginning of a little island, all in the matter of seconds. So, but what if you want to fill a large chunk of area with water? I'll show you what you need to do. Let's just create some windows. Yeah, I turned off water effects. That's what it looks like. So if you want to have the normal effect, just go into settings. And there you can see water through glass, turn it on, then it's normal again. Also adjust the glass position so it's right at the edge of the water. I would just put everything on. So imagine you want to fill up this whole tank with water, or maybe drown those cute and annoying fat rats. What you can do is just stand over here, select the bottomless pot, and pour. Let's see what happens. As you can see, now it stopped. And what we have is a little water pillar and a bit of the floor filled. A better way would be to use an easy to destroy material, like sand or earth, and create a little ring where you want to fill the area. One block away from the windows and one block below where you want the water to be. This is also the method I use in my Hyrule build. So what you want to do now is pour the water. Let's see how many blocks we are away. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 over here. And let's just go to the middle and pour away. See how many ground we covered with one pour. Now just pour again. And once more.
That's a penis!
This way you're done with three short pours. And we'll also do it over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Go in the middle and pour away. And now we only need two pours. Yeah, this way you can fill a water tank pretty fast, and all you have to do now is just destroy all the remaining blocks. I like to do it this way, with the binoculars. We create a beginning, and now you just take the binocular camera over here. So all the blocks are in one line, and then just destroy. Like this. And the whole line is gone, and you collected every block at the same time. You can also, of course, do it like this. Although this method has one little problem, there will always be one or two blocks left out because the developers programmed it wrong. I don't know why. And then you still have to swim and collect everything. And now what we also can do is use the tree stump and create some of those shifting sand blocks. And if you have finished the unlimited item challenge on the Explore Shores Island, you will have them totally free. And now you just take them and use the transformer trowel and remove the ground below you. This is also one way to remove those blocks you created before. I would also recommend to create some food which lets you walk and swim freely underwater like a fish. Wait, I show you how you can do it. Where is it? Over there. All you need is one fish you can cook, like the mackerel or the salmon or stuff like that. Also, your villagers should fish them up. Some potatoes and some oil. And this way you can swim freely for 2 minutes. I think 2 minutes, maybe 1 minute. This way you'll be a bit faster. Oh, those are still the blocks I made below. Yeah, I should have used some different blocks for those. Maybe sand or earth. And now we created some nice... what is it called? A panorama aquarium? Or a little manta ray friend. Yay! So he can see the world with our eyes. Go and be free, my friend. Yeah, and I think that's all for today's episode of Building Techniques. If you like this new series, well, it's not new, but the second part now, after a long time, please tell me in the comments also what kind of blocks you would like to see. Maybe some tricks with magnet blocks, or windows, or roof pieces. I don't know. Maybe you have some ideas. I'm really curious to hear what you have to say. Or to read what you have to say. Yeah, and that's already it. So, please consider to give this video a like. I help you, you help me. That's the way it goes. Right, little mentor friend? Yes? Yes? Yes! And I'll see you in the next video. So, have a great day, morning or evening, or a nice beach day, or have a look at an aquarium somewhere with a friend. Until next time. Bye! Mentor Rice also saying bye. Yay!